Since 2002, a team of scientists from the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute has been studying whale falls at different depths within the Monterey Canyon, which have revealed new insights about how these systems function. Dead whales that sink to the seafloor represent a massive pulse of energy to an otherwise nutrient-poor environment, and this feast in the deep can host diverse and abundant communities of organisms. When whales first arrive at the seafloor, flesh-devouring animals like hagfish, sharks, crabs, amphipods, polychaete worms, and rat-tail fish, seen here, strip soft tissue from bone. Once devoid of flesh, bacteria begin to colonize and, in turn, bacterial grazers and others come to feed on the concentration of food that the decomposing skeleton provides. Most of these organisms appear to be background taxa, organisms commonly found at the depth and habitat type where the whale fall occurs. However, at whale falls they may occur in higher densities than normal, such as these brittle stars. Many new species have been found through this research, including these bone-devouring Osedax worms, which specialize in digesting bone through the help of bacterial symbionts. Most animals aren't dependent upon whale carcasses for their survival, and even the Osedax worms can utilize bones of other organisms and are not dependent upon whale bone for their survival. Surprisingly, this research showed that whale carcasses can degrade rapidly, depending on the size and age of the whale at death and the environmental conditions where the whale fall is located. We found that carcasses degraded in less than a decade, most likely due to the high abundance of Osedax worms, which excavate the bones with root-like structures that bore into the bone, fragmenting and degrading it. 15 species of Osedax have been found in Monterey Canyon, and they appear to occupy different niches. Some break down the laminated surface of bones, some bore deeply into bone, and still others feed on fragments of bone buried in the sediment. Several new species of bone-devouring snails have also been found at these whales and may contribute to this rapid degradation. Once the feast has ended, it's back to famine for these inhabitants of the deep. This is Lonnie Lunston at the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute.